Hello, today is Monday, December 14th, and we're going to be reading from 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 15 through 25. Let's read together. The Lord who chose you is holy, so you should be holy in all that you do. It is written, "Be holy because I am holy." You know that you were not bought with these things that can pass away like silver or gold. Instead, you were bought with the priceless blood of Christ. He is a perfect lamb. He doesn't have any flaws at all. He was chosen before God created the world, but he came into the world for your sake in these last days. You have made yourself pure by obeying the truth, so you have an honest and true love for each other. So love one another deeply from your hearts. You have been born again by means of the living word of God. His word lasts forever. You were not born again from a seed that will die. You were born from a seed that can't die. It is written, "All people are like grass. All their glory is like the flowers in the field. The grass dries up, the flowers fall to the ground. But the word of the Lord stands forever. And this is the word that was preached to you." Amen. Amen. So today and tomorrow, there's a theme. There's a theme of the difference that salvation, or when you meet Jesus Christ, you're saved, right? The salvation brings in the life of the Christian. And in 1 Peter, it's going to ask the believer to do certain things, you know, certain things that you cannot do unless you have met Jesus and been saved, okay? So today, let's first look together at verse 20. It says, "He was chosen before God created the world. He came into the world for your sake in these last days." So in Mom and Dad's version, it actually says in there, "He was chosen as a ransom," right? So ransom, Peter's readers, when they hear this, what they're going to think is they're going to think about a slave, right? A slave, he's an actual piece of object that his owner owns, right? And then in order to free the slave, in order for him to be free, there has to be a ransom or some kind of price has to be paid. So that's what they're going to be thinking, okay? The freeing of a slave or a redemption. So God chose Jesus Christ as our ransom. So he is the price that was paid. I know we say these Christian words a lot, but unless Jesus died on the cross, we cannot be saved, right? All of our sins, God didn't just say, "Okay, I'm a nice God, I'll let you go." No, no, no. Someone had to pay this price, and it was Jesus Christ. And here it says, you know, before the whole world began, God chose Jesus to do this wonderful act of love, okay? And then look together with me at verse 22. It says, "You have made yourself pure by obeying the truth, so you have an honest and true love for each other. Love each other deeply from your heart." And then in Mom and Dad's version again, it's a little bit different each time, so I want to show you a little bit more complete picture. So it says, "Cleanse from sins when you obey the truth." So it says, "Now you must show a sincere love to one another as brothers and sisters." So first here, it's when you obey. So it's when you're obeying, then you're cleansed from your sins, okay? So sometimes, I know sometimes we're waiting to feel like we want to obey, and then, oh, you know, I don't know if my life is changing at all. I don't know. I don't really want to obey. I don't want to do anything. But when we submit ourselves to God, during that act of obeying, God is very powerful, because when we obey, God's power works, okay? And it says the Holy Spirit, he's the one that makes us holy. We cannot make ourselves holy. So when you obey, then something magic is starting to happen, okay? You cannot make yourself holy, but God does it when you obey and then when you have faith, okay? And in the bottom part here, it also says a sincere love for each other as brothers and sisters. So here there's two loves that are said. The word love, there's two, okay? One is Philadelphia, not Philly like cheesesteak. It's not a place in the U.S., but Philadelphia like the brotherly love. The love that a non-saved, non-Christian can show their best friend, right? "Hey, buddy, we're like best friends, and you're awesome, and we'll be friends forever," right? Like that kind of is Philadelphia, just brotherly love, okay? Just people-to-people love, and of course that can fail, right? So there's that love, and then also the agape love. Agape love is kind of like that God-like sacrificial love. So this love is sincere. It's not selfish. It's not about, you know, if I'm friends with him, maybe then, you know, I'll have, you know, more better social life, or, you know, if I'm friends with this guy, like, there's no calculating when you're loving someone in this way, okay? You're not trying to manipulate them or, you know, change their mind or do anything. It's a love that's selfless and sacrificial, the love that God showed us. And he didn't want anything from us when he saved us by Jesus Christ. He didn't want anything. He doesn't need anything from us. It's a selfless love, okay? Those two kinds of love. And then one last one, please go with me to verse 23. It says, you have been born again by means of the living word of God. His word lasts forever. You were not born from a seed that will die. You were born from a seed that cannot die. So here it's, your new life is going to last forever. So when you're born, we say born again in Christ. When you accept Jesus Christ and you have a new life in you, then it's forever. It's eternal. It's never going to change. And this new life, it comes from the word of God, which is the good news of Jesus Christ, right? The gospel message. And then this, the love that we keep saying, you know, all this love, unless you have Jesus Christ, the foundation has to be, I accepted Jesus Christ, and that word, that new life is what's on the bottom. Then you cannot do all the loving things. The most you can do is be nice to people. But once they get on your nerve, then you'll be like, I'm losing patience. I don't love you anymore. Or, you know, in a worldly sense, we say, oh, you're so beautiful, I love you. But then, oh, you make me mad, I don't love you anymore. Okay, it changes. But the bottom foundation, if it's Jesus Christ, he died for my sins. And because I'm growing in Jesus Christ new every day, we grow in a love that is a God love, agape love. Okay? So let's pray and continue to love one another with this God love, agape love. Let's let the gospel truth shine in our lives. So if you've accepted Jesus Christ, you are living a new life, not a slightly better life, a more nicer life, but it's a totally new life. It's a spiritual thing. It's not just earthly thing. And you are not going to die and disappear. You are going to, all of eternity, you're going to be with Jesus Christ. Going to be with God in heaven, and this is going to go on and on and on. So right now, when we accept Jesus Christ, we're living a life that is very, very different. We are loving in a way that's very, very different than we can love on our own. It's God's agape love. So let's pray today together. Dear God, we pray, Lord God, that you would help us to obey you. We want your power to be in our life. God, we want your work to be done in our life and through us, that you would transform us day by day, that we would be glorifying to you. God, I pray, Lord, that we would always be leaning into what you want to do and to love you more, to love others more. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. See you tomorrow.